Welcome to a lovely edition of Broomstick Only. Let's have some fun. We're going to work on some skills today. We're going to work on some overhead work, opening up that shoulder a little bit for some mobility work while working on some functional overhead positioning. So let's have some fun with that. But first things first, let's warm up. So we're going to use a snatch grip first to warm up. So we're going to get our feet just kind of comfortably in a hip-width stance. We're just outside so you can feel that good contact with the feet. Nice wide grip so the bar kind of sits at the hip crease. And we're going to just sort of pull that bar up to that high and outside position and then lower back down. So we're not trying to go too fast, we're just moving smooth. High and outside, good position, back down. One more time, high and outside, back down. From here, we'll pull high and outside, turn over into that overhead position. Come back in reverse, and then we're going to pull up, turn over, overhead position, come back down, and last one, pull up, turn over, and then overhead. Come down behind the neck, and from here, we're going to separate those feet a little bit more into our squat stance. We're going to squeeze and set the ribs and hips, draw back into that good morning, keeping the big toes on the floor, standing tall, and then rotate at the low rib. Gentle rotation here. So we come back through, rotation, other side. We come back through. We're going to draw the hips back into our good morning again. So nice positioning, standing tall, and rotate. Come back through center, and rotate. Come back through center, good morning. Up and rotate, back through and rotate, and back through. Good. From here, let's do some wide grip shoulder press. So keeping the ribs in, press the bar in the overhead position, come back down, press in the overhead, back down, press in the overhead, now come to the front, back into that nice positioning. Now, from here, we're going to take the hands palm forward. We're going to take the bar behind the back. Now again, this is extremely challenging, and I don't need to see this very high. What we're going to do is take this bar up as far overhead as we can. Now our goal is to keep our body still and our arms straight. So wherever that body stops, where those arms won't allow, just stop your range and come back down. Set the ribs and glutes. Let's bring the bar up and over in that position, and then come back down. Good. Keep those ribs in. Pull up, and then come back down. Good. One more time, come up, and come back down. Good. Now, from here, we bring the bar back around. We're going to go into a narrow grip, so both thumb and thumb. We're going to turn the hands around into that kind of curl grip. That. We're going to pull the bar up into that curl position. Press the bar overhead. Keeping the ribs in, we're going to press back in those shoulders. Come back overhead, keeping the elbows in front of the bar. Then we're going to take it back down, extending and stretching out those biceps. Curl the bar up, elbows in front. Press the bar up overhead, ribs in. Press back, come back overhead, and pull down. Elbows staying in front, take it back down. Good. Let's do that again. Curl the bar up under the chin, elbows in front. Press the bar up overhead. Press back. Come back overhead. Pull it back down, elbows in front. And bring it back into that front position at the hip. Nice. Let's turn those hands over. From here, we're going to work that high pull again, but in a narrow grip. So again, if you need to check your hands, thumb and thumb. We are going to pull the bar up to that high and outside position, come back down. Ribs in, pull the bar, high and outside, back down. Pull the bar, high and outside, back down. Do two more of these. Pull, back down, and pull, back down. Now that's going to be a key position now moving forward. But first things first, we're going to stretch out those arms a bit. We're going to pull. Now, keeping the bar where it's at for the most part, we're going to roll the elbows through as best we can without pushing the bar into our throat. Roll it back and come back down. Pull to the sternum. Roll. going to continue building from that, but we're going to pull into our cubic rotation. So we're going to pull the bar to the sternum. My elbows are going to stay exactly where they are right now. My shoulders are going to stay down, so we're not shrugging our shoulders up to our ears. But we are going to pull that bar up to that 90 degree, as deep as you can get to that position, and then come back down, keeping those arms level, taking your time. This isn't meant to be fast. Pull the bar, keeping those arms in that good positioning. Come back down. Good. Pull the bar back overhead. Come back down. Pull the bar. Good. Come back down. One more. Pull the bar. And come back down. Good. Lower the bar to the hip. We're going to work through that roll again. So we're going to pull the sternum, roll the elbows through, roll them back, and take it down for two. Roll, just kind of smoothing that out a little bit. Go a little faster if you'd like. For three, roll through. For four, roll through. For five. And down. Excellent. Give your arms a little shake. Take a moment. Whew, that got me a little warm. That got my arms a little heated up as well. So again, just a few key positions. Just working on that range of motion that we have. And that's the nice thing about this light kind of weightless apparatus is that we have to physically put our arms where we need to be and not rely on an external load to do it for us. So it's really helpful to get to those positions or press into that range of that position that we might struggle with as we move into that nice front rack position. Now, what we're gonna work on is some pressing. So we're gonna work on some shoulder pressing. So that is the key foundational movement of our jerks, our presses, all that lovely pressing series. So we're gonna take our PVC pipe again. Feet, hip width stance, toes can be slightly turned out if you need to, like myself, all right? Thumb and a thumb. We are going to pull the bar up in that little tall muscle clean. Elbows are going to be in front of the bar. They don't have to be full front rack, but in front of the bar for sure. Feet are connected to the ground. Glutes are tight, ribs are tight. We're going to retract the chin. We're going to press the bar straight up into that overhead position. Nice and solid overhead, actively pressing to the bar. Let's pull the bar down, 3 second pull. Three, two, one. That beautiful position. Nice and tight. Press. Holding. Now pull down. Three, two, one. Good. Press. Holding. Pull the bar down. Three, two, one. Good. Two more. Press. Holding. Pull it down. Three, two, one. Last one. Press. Pull down. Three, two, one. Good. Bring the bar down. Shake your arms out. So again, with that active pull down of the bar in that 3 second eccentric, you're really going to feel the engagement factor of the arms, the lats, the pecs, all that good stuff. Especially that tension, as you may find in that rack position, maybe a little tight there. So it's a nice way to work on building that position from the top down, not just trying to go from the bottom up. So from there, we're gonna move into some push press fundamentals. We're gonna work again on that pause dip. We're gonna work a pause push press, which can be a little awkward. And then we are going to work on a pause overhead dip. So we're gonna work on the receiving position of the jerk, the power jerk, I should say. So a couple things with this. We want to make sure that we are focusing on a vertical dip, shoulder staying over the hip, and those feet are going to remain flat for the majority of these drills. Until we start actually doing the push press, then you might find you get a little lift off the heels as our hips and knees extend. Okay, so let's bring that bar back into that thumb and the thumb, so our hands are just outside our shoulders. We're going to pull the bar to the sternum. We're going to roll it through in that nice front rack position. From here, we are going to dip straight down. Hips under the shoulders, feet are flat, knees go slightly out. And we're going to just push those legs bar overhead, let's dip. Hips under the shoulders, feet are flat. Now stand. Keep pressing the bar. Dip and hold. Knees are out. Weight through the midfoot. Stand prep or stand. One more time. Dip and hold. And stand. Bring the bar down. Good front rack position. Let's bring the bar back to the hip. And relax for a second. Nice. Okay. So key thing with that pause, push press. Pause, push press is tough because we're stopping the momentum that we normally have in our push press. You're not going to feel too awkward with this with no load, but as you start adding load to that, you're going to find that that weight feels a lot heavier when we're just trying to push with the legs because we're isolating one piece of the push press, the drive. And the drive can sometimes be a little weaker depending on our comfort level with that put or that leg drive. Right, in our cleans, our snatches, all that kind of stuff. So we want to make sure that we focus in on that drive straight up through those legs into that nice press. So very good. If you'd like to pause the video or scroll back, do that sequence again. It's not a bad idea because you're going to feel the weight in different parts of your body. It gives you a great opportunity to focus on as you dip, staying through that midfoot the entire time so we're not dipping into our toes or dipping into our heels and losing our balance backwards, because that dip is crucial in our push press, our power jerks, our split jerks, because we want to make sure we stay square and stable in the foot so we can drive all that energy into the bar so we can get underneath it. So, you want to take that down? 2 to 3 times, plenty. Take it down, have some fun. We're going to skip over and we're going to play around with some jerk balances. But first kind of jerk balance we're going to work with is for the power jerk. So what we're going to do is a little different. I'm going to face the front for you guys. My feet are going to be under my hips. I'm going to go thumb and a thumb distance away. I'm going to pull the bar into that front rack position. I'm going to push the bar to my forehead position. So my arms are about a 90 degree. The bar is pretty close, and I like to get that press like I'm just shoulder pressing. So it follows the same bar path. When I say the word go, you are going to press yourself down in that receiving position of the jerk. Now your feet are probably going to move out slightly, but the key thing is there's no upward momentum or no down up, it's just down. So it's going to feel slightly strange. The key thing about this timing is when our feet land, our arms should be locked out in a good strong overhead position. So let's give it a shot. Let's get our feet under our hips, thumb and a thumb. We're going to pull the bar to the sternum. Roll the elbows through. Set through the ribs and glutes. Chin back. Brush up to the forehead. Tight. And go. Holding that position, press into the bar. Stand. Bring your feet back under if they shifted out a bit. Come back down to the front rack position so we can feel the tension. Chin back. Forehead. Go. Stand. Feet come back under, bar comes to the front rack, one more time, tight, press the forehead, go! Stand, feet come back under, bar comes down, and bar comes down. Good, nice work you guys. So it's a great way, timing drill. All right, so we've worked those in other work sets with the snatch, that high pull hold to turnover. It's a great way to work on timing, lockout, and just really get that aggressive punch that we need in our jerks. So now we're going to take a step back and work on some footwork in terms of our split jerk. So let's get ourselves set up in our squat stance. We're going to take our thumb and a thumb distance. We're going to pull the bar up, take it up, and bring it to the shoulders. So we don't have to worry about our face. We can just focus on our feet. Let's step forward. Step back. Hips are square, back toe is on the floor, ball of the foot is on the floor, but the heel's off the ground. My front knee, soft and bent, but over top of the heel. Hips are square and stacked, my back knee is soft. From here, I should feel 50-50 weight, nice and balanced. I'm gonna do a half recovery with that front foot, little pull back, and now we're gonna dip and drive. So we're gonna dip, step, and press all at one time. Ready, go, dip, Now check your feet. Are you in that perfect start position that we just had? If you are, awesome. If not, fix it. Now let's do a partial recover. Bring the bar back down. Set. Go. Check your feet. Fix them. Partial recover. Bar down. Ready? Go. Fix your feet if you need to. Hold for a moment. Full recovery. Let's bring the bar behind the neck. Good. We're going to do some more. I'm going to turn to the side for you so we can see that from the side if you need to. Set that stance up again. Find your positioning. Find that nice balanced position through the back of the foot or the front foot. We'll pull the front foot back. Partial. Set. Go. Fix your feet if you need to. Make sure you're in that good balance. Partial recover. Bar comes down. Set. Go. Set. Recover. Bar down. One more time. Go. Fix your feet if you need to. Full recovery. Bar to the front. Bar down. Nice. All right. So now, if you'd like to go through those two variations of jerk balances, scroll back, take it down a couple rounds. They both offer some really important lessons, one of which is timing of the lockout, which you can transition to that split jerk. As soon as that front foot hits or our feet hit in that split, we need to be locked out. So that timing piece still comes in handy in that crossover from our power jerk to our split jerk. Now continuing forward, what we're going to do is move into a sequence and a little complex. We are going to do very similar to what we did last time. We are going to do 3 push press, 2 power jerk, then we're going to go behind the neck, 1 behind the neck split jerk, 1 in front split jerk. So we're going to have a chance to get that face out of the way and work our footwork. All right, I'm going to turn to the side so you guys can see my body position. So again, feet are under the hips. We're starting with the push press because that's that heart of the dip. Set, pull the bar up to the sternum, roll it through. Chin back, tight glutes and ribs, push press. Come back down. Set that rack position, push press. Come back down. Set, push press. Good, come back down. Power jerk, set. Hold that position for a beat or two. Stand, fix your feet if you need to. Come back down. Ready, power jerk. Holding, pressing into that bar. Stand, feet come back under. Behind the neck split jerk. Tight, set. Go. Good. Hold, check your feet, check your balance. Full recover. Bar to the front rack. Have to get the chin out of the way. Pull back. Jerk. Fix your feet, fix your balance. Front foot, back foot, down, and relax. Excellent. Beautiful work. Now, if you'd like to do that sequence again, about 3-5 rounds perhaps, pause the video, scroll back, do it with me again, take it down, but remember, the skills we focus on from the beginning to the end, just build and build in intensity. Our push press, we're working on that good vertical dip and drive to build that extension of the legs and that leg drive. We continue that into our power jerk. Power jerk, we work on driving ourselves under the bar, but we're landing in that squat-ish stance or slightly inside squat stance. We continue moving through that into our split jerk as we punch ourselves under the bar, building off of that dip to drive and that punch. And then we just have to find that footwork as we drive ourselves down into that split position. So keep focused on those feet, focus on those positions. Now, let's build our squat up a little bit and work on some squat development. So let's take our PVC and just put it on the floor for now. We're gonna get our feet under our body We're just gonna do an air squat, because again, we haven't done a lot of squatting today. We've been mostly in the split or power positions. So nice and set, take a 3 second down, 3, 2, 1, little pause, and stand. Okay, so that's pretty tight here on my end. So hopefully that squat felt a little better than mine did, but we'll see how it feels at the end of our work set. So what we're gonna work on today is we're gonna work on some single leg work. We're gonna go back and forth from the RDL to the pistol. We're gonna move into our Kang squat and then a narrow grip overhead squat. So let's take it down a little bit. So we're gonna get our feet under our hips. Our toe is gonna stay in a kickstand position. Hips are square, hands need to be to the front like we're holding a dumbbell just to engage that upper back. Let's draw the hips back, bringing the hand to the knee or just below, feeling those hamstrings. Then we're gonna stand tall. From here, we're gonna take the body down, hip to heel in that squat position, focusing our weight through the main foot. And push through that leg. Good. Set the hips up again. Draw the hips back into our RDL. Feel that hamstring. Say hello. Stand tall. Reset. Squat. Focusing all that weight through that balancing leg. Push through that leg. Do one more. Set. Draw the hip back, nice flat foot. Stand tall. Squat to your depth. And stand. Good. Now let's switch feet. Other foot's down. Kickstand leg. Hips are square. Active through that upper back. Draw the hip back to that nice RDL. Feel the hamstring. Stand tall. Now pull the hip to the heel. Focus on that balancing leg. Good. And stand. Draw the hip back. Feel that hinge. Stand tall. Now squat. Body stays upright, reaching that midfoot. And stand. Good. Hinge. Squat stance now. So regular squat stance. If you want to use a hand reference to the chest and the ribs, you can. It just gives us a nice chance to see if we're breaking or losing position. So nice and set through the ribs and hips. Draw the hips back into our hinge. Feel the hamstrings. Now pull the hips into our air squat. Now push into our good morning. Stand tall. Good. Draw the hips back. Pull into our squat. And stand tall. Or sorry, push into that good morning. And then stand tall. Good. Draw the hips back. Pull into our squat. And push into that good morning. And stand tall. Beautiful. Okay, now let's take that PVC pipe. This is gonna get tough. All right, we're gonna start with the narrow, and we're gonna work as deep as we possibly can. So natural squat stance, thumb and a thumb. We're gonna pull the bar up, so we're in our pressing or jerk grip. We're gonna shoulder press, feet are in that regular squat stance, pushing into that bar. Take those hips to the heels, keep pressing into the bar, press, 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 press. Listen to that body, focus on your positions, and stand. Nice. Take it down, hips to heels. Take your time, take your time, take your time. And stand. Good. Now pressing into that bar, take it down. And stand. Woo! Bring that bar down, good rack position, and down. We'll put on the floor for a second. Now let's test that air squat. So regular stance, 3 seconds down, 3, 2, 1, and stand. Beautiful. That felt way better for me. Hopefully it felt way better for you. Now if you'd like to redo that work set, please do so. Scroll back, do it again, anywhere from 3 to 5 times. It's gonna get those legs fired up. It's gonna give you a chance to really work that squat mechanic and get that squat under control. Thank you for joining me today. Work on some overhead work, some overhead skill, plus some squat development. Appreciate you guys coming out to work these skills. It's tough, work, but it's what makes the work better. So thank you so much. As always, everyone, work for quality, have tons of fun. We'll see you next week for some more fun.